This is Dr. William Pawluk. This video is going to be about the intensity of pulsed magnetic fields, or PEMFs. Intensity matters. There's much information about intensity. Manufacturers make claims about their device intensities and saying that their device intensities are the only ones that work. This is clearly untrue. I have worked with PEMF devices of all intensities. I have read thousands of research articles on the effectiveness of PEMFs for various health conditions. In fact, I've published a chapter in a scientific book on this. The scientific term for it is dosimetry. This is the intensity of the stimulus, the amount of time, the volume of tissue being stimulated, and the desired outcome. This is all based on two laws of physics, Faraday's law and the inverse square rule. PEMFs help the body by stimulating energy or charge of the tissues. Faraday's law requires that the more charge needed for healing, the higher the intensity the PEMF needs to be. Faraday's law is a scientific term, dB/dt, where d is change, b is intensity, and t is time. This means the change in intensity over the change in time. The higher the intensity reached in the shortest time, the higher the dB/dt. The higher this value, the greater the energy produced in the tissues. Some high-intensity PEMFs have dB/dts high enough to cause muscles to contract. I have found them to be very effective. The other law is the inverse square rule. Magnetic field intensities drop off the farther the tissue being stimulated is from the source of the magnetic field. So based on Faraday's law, intensities need to be high enough to generate enough charge to create change in the tissues. The amount of energy needed right next to an applicator may be much lower if the tissue is next to the applicator. However, if one is treating the entire lung, heart, or liver as examples, then clearly the higher magnetic field intensity levels are necessary to provide sufficient stimulation to the entire organ. Some examples. 2 inches from a 1,000 Gauss stimulator, the magnetic field has dropped to around 20 Gauss. This is a 98% drop in intensity, but 20 Gauss is still clinically effective. A 100 microtesla, or 1 Gauss PEMF, at 3 inches into the body drops to 1.2 microtesla, a whopping 99% drop in intensity. So there is little magnetic field left to generate charge or to heal. One review of the medical literature actually found that very low intensity PEMFs around 100 microtesla provide little benefit for a number of different chronic health conditions. Most research showing benefit for specific health conditions used magnetic fields greater than 30 to 50 Gauss. Much of this is covered in my soon-to-be-released book, Power Tools for Health, where I provide over 500 references for over 50 health conditions and topics on what intensities worked best. PEMF systems should be selected based on the unique needs of an individual. Intensities range from extremely low to low, medium, high, and very high. Extremely low would be around 10 microtesla. Low would be between 1 and 10 Gauss. Medium would be between 10 and 100 Gauss. High would be up to 4,000 Gauss, and extremely high would be MRI machines between 20,000 and 40,000 Gauss. Most clinical studies use intensities ranging from 10 to 1,000 Gauss. In fact, there are new recently FDA-approved PEMFs that treat depression, and they're also used for many other health conditions. They get up to around 4,000 Gauss, or higher even. Low-intensity PEMFs need more and longer treatments. Medium to high-intensity PEMFs can improve symptoms in less than a month, with just minutes a day of treatment. I've seen a number of muscular problems disappear with just 2 to 3 hours of treatment using high-intensity PEMFs. Reality is, people can't spend a lot of time treating various parts of their bodies. That means that a whole-body magnetic system of sufficient intensity, usually equal to or greater than 30 Gauss, does the job much more efficiently. I wish you all the best in your health and your journey with PEMFs. Thank you.